Digging in tight. Almost full throttle. Whoa! Whoa! Yeah! The front end is a little loose. Second session, 11:30. This is my second time on track testing with Emrys. Actually trying to go fast, riding for myself, not teaching rider training. So rider training, I always find, slows me down. I have to like break past that warp speed barrier, where warp speed looks like a little slower motion. Because then when you're riding freaking rider training speeds, you know, you lose that sense of warp. You lose that warp speed ability. I don't know how to say it. The ability to go warp speed and not seem like it's warp speed. The bike always seems really fast once you get on it after going so slow. Let's give a little clap here. One, two, three, four. Trying to sync all the audios from all the cameras so I can sync them up on my Vegas Pro, whatever, 1213 program I use. Still saving up for that laptop so I can edit stuff faster, render faster. Like, you're talking freaking almost $5,000 for what I want to do with all the SSD, Samsung 960 SSD, M2, ATI3 drives. They add up for like 3 terabytes. So just $2,000 of freaking just the hard drives. All right, front stands off. Let's go. This is it, we're hitting a 51. We're hitting a 51. Should have enough fuel. Still, let's double check. I just changed my gearing also, of course. Oh man, that's tough with the glove on. Oh no, I dropped my air pressure. Okay. Not so much, enough for some laps. Okay, so I'm just gonna go test this new sprocket setup. I switched from a 1642 to a 1644. So now I'd be able to stay in third. Everything about the rear wheel, I got the lock, all good. And I softened the front suspension, one compression, from like 7 to 8. Woo! Try launch control. Up to this gate on my first opening lap. Dragging elbow. There's third gear. There's my first right. Be a little cautious always. The first quarter is even with tire warmers. My wheelbase is shortened also. I had to tighten the wheelbase with that sprocket set up, the 44 from the 42. The bike switches a little quicker because of that. Not necessarily a good thing, it's going to be less stable. down to third again. Now we're hitting third gear. A little wider entrance. Right to the blue. Holy shit, that was tight. Ooh, the corner, I was talking to you guys too much. No, I don't want to go across that shit. That lap's fucked up. Oh, good buddy, sideways. Some really fast racer I'm sure I'm going to go against later. Buddy in the Honda, he is awesome. I remember him. He goes. Okay, stay in third. Little guy stays in already on. Bullshit. Oh no. Just 26. Another two laps maybe. Whoa, see that rear slide? My passing corner. again. A little wide right there. Whoa! My foot's in the wrong spot now. Losing a second right there. Well, at least a half a second. Okay, getting tight. Front end is a little loose. One more lap. 19 on fuel, 19 kilometers. Go for it, but not a race pace. Place to pass. Hey, there's Barry Russell, I think. This is it for laps so far. So the passing says around the outside, set him up for this corner. There's Barry Russell, KMT, Motorsports. Get a massage, some fuel. Alright, so that gearing was nice. I could achieve the same gearing if I change my front sprocket and instead and get a longer wheelbase, so I could look at the graph and match it up for 15, like maybe 40. 1542, get longer wheelbase, much longer wheelbase. Yeah, let's soften up the front compression one more. I'm not braking that hard, actually. Let's go for just a couple laps. I did 60 and 58. Lean angle. Let's go back out, try a softer on the front. I'm at 12. I'll be right back. Do you mind helping me, Evan? I gotta make my massage. Warmer, please.